Good morning, cadets. Today let us quickly go through the slides related to the chapter number 6, that is political parties. So in the chapter number 6 in political parties, we studied about various aspects of political parties. Okay, we studied about the meaning of political party, which we studied in very detailed manner. We also studied about the political parties reflect the fundamental political division of a society. We studied the elements of political party, that is leader, active members and followers. These are the few pictures related to the election propaganda during the time of elections in Tamil Nadu. Then we studied about the major topic of functions of political party. Here we studied first function, that is to contest election. Second function, that is policies and programs. Third one, lawmaking function, generally done by the parliament in India, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So the passing law. We also studied that a political party which win the general elections, that is Lok Sabha elections. In India, it is if a political party succeeded in getting 272 seats, such party will be declared as ruling party, and the ruling party will form the government, and once the government is formed, definitely they run the government for the welfare of the people. What happens to the party which is the second one, that is in elections there is no runners up. In champion, sports champion, you can see winners and runners, but elections there is no runners. But still, the party which lost the election or the party which got next highest seat will act as opposition party. Opposition party is very important in a democracy, because opposition parties are very crucial in controlling the ruling party. That's why the famous quote says that the Prime Minister of England worried what his opposition party leader is doing more than what his own wife is doing. So because opposition party leader definitely a good threat on his power. We also studied that political parties generally make the public opinion, shaping a public opinion. I explained you what is called public opinion. Opinion of the people or a public is called public opinion. How public create an opinion? Based on the inputs provided to them by the social media platforms or the broadcast, which include TV, radio, newspaper, magazines, journals, or including Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, Instagram, whatever it may be. So this is how we get the inputs, and based on the inputs people create their own opinion. Such opinions are very important in a democracy, because these opinions can shake the government, or definitely it will help the opposition party to win election. That is what we speak of public opinion. Every political party definitely involved in one or other way of welfare measure schemes. That is what we are going to study. We have studied that every party is involved in some kind of social welfare measures. This is a picture related to, that is a protest in various places. We also studied why we need a political party. Many times we feel that political parties are, all political parties are very corrupt, leaders are corrupt, so it's a waste of money, etc., etc. But still, we cannot deny the need of political parties, because without the political party, we cannot elect the government. Because in a country like India, where we have huge population, so it's very difficult to select the people. That's why political parties are inevitable. Then we also studied about the party systems in the world. We have studied a one-party system, two-party system, and multi-party system. We studied that one-party system, example in China, where only one political party exists, there is no opposition in China. One-party system is not good, because the party definitely turned into dictatorship party. So naturally, people of that in that particular country generally don't get any freedom of, or freedom to express their opinion, or freedom of choice. Then we also studied about two-party system, which is generally considered as the best party system, where you can see that two political parties, one is very powerful opposition, at the same time very important, very powerful ruling party. So there is no much difference regarding winning margin of opposition and ruling party, but still two-party system considered as best. You always remember the example for two-party system. One is United States of America, second one England. United States of America, we have two-party, and United Kingdom also example for two-party. Okay, Labour Party and Conservative Party, then we have Republicans and Democrats. This is about how morality plays a great role in politics. Then we also studied about popular participation. Very, very discouraging that in India, less than 45% people are actually participate in the election process. Presently, because of lot of social awareness, people are going and voting, but otherwise the participation of people in politics is very, very less than many of the Scandinavian countries, because one of the reason is that people in India are very, very the least bothered about party or about the entire concept of political process. Then we studied about national parties. What is the definition to call as a national party? A national party is a party that secures at least 6% of total votes in Lok Sabha or in assembly elections in at least in 4 states and win at least 4 seats in Lok Sabha, as it is recognized as a national party. Please remember, 6% of total votes across at least in 4 states or 4 MPs, that is called national parties. But the second party, that is called regional party. Regional party is a party which is very, very powerful in a region. It secures at least 6% of total votes in election of legislative assembly, that is a state election, at least 2 MLAs. Then we studied about national parties like Bharatiya Janata Party, their ideologies, and presently they as a ruling party. Then we studied about Indian National Congress. The main ideology of Indian National Congress, you remember this, that is to support secularism, welfare of weaker sections and minorities. Try to remember the key ideology of national political party like Indian National Congress. Presently, Indian National Congress is seen with the alliance called UPA, that is United Progressive Alliance. The United Progressive Alliance is presently an opposition party. Then we also studied about BSP, that is Bahujan Samajwadi Party. Bahujan Samaj Party, BSP, started by Kansiram. Remember that is BSP seeks to represent and secure power for Bahujan Samaj, which includes Dalits, Adivasi, OBC and religious minorities. So in which states they are very powerful? BSP is very powerful in Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Uttarakhand, Delhi and Punjab. Who is the present leader of BSP? Kumari Mayawati, the present leader of BSP. Then we studied about the Communist Party of India, Marxist. This is an offshoot of Communist Party of India, which was started in 1925, split in 1964. So CPIM supports Leninism, socialism, secularism and democracy, and definitely oppose imperialism and communalism. Imperialism is nothing but economically powerful countries controlling the weak nations. It's called imperialism. What America is doing today is imperialism. Communalism, which we studied, that is clash between the religious groups. CPI, that is Communist Party of India, which is started in 1925, support Karl Marx ideology and Lenin's ideology. Marxism and Leninism. CPI is very powerful in states like Kerala, West Bengal, Punjab, Andhra Pradesh and in Tamil Nadu. Next, which what we studied is NCP, that is Nationalist Congress Party, started by Sharad Pawar, B.S. Sangma. Majorly, BSP is powerful in Maharashtra, Meghalaya, Manipur and Assam. Presently, it is very powerful in Maharashtra because of Sharad Pawar. So, what is the major ideology of NCP? That is, NCP wants high officials in government of India to be confined to the natural born citizens of the country. Means NCP says that Prime Minister, President, Vice President should be given to the natural born. Means the citizens who are born in India, not the acquired citizenship. Means those who apply for Indian citizenship and get the citizenship. That is called acquired. Then state parties. Okay. Samajwadi Party, Samta Party, Rashtriya Janata Dal, Janata Dal, Sikkim Democratic Party. Then we studied according to various states. I repeat once again, please observe carefully the party symbols. If you are targeting 100 out of 100 in social science, then you should be very, very thorough with even with the minute aspects. Okay, state wise I am displaying Assam Gana Parishad, Nagaland, Sikkim Democratic Front, Jharkhand Mukti Morcha, JMM. Please carefully observe the party symbols. For example, you see Manipur People's Party symbol is bicycle. Okay. That is about Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Dravida Munnetra Kalagam, Pattali Makkal Kalchi, Telugu Desam Party. You see, bicycle is a very common. 2-3 parties already to have the same. Now you see, All India Anna Dravida, DMK and Kerala Congress symbols are same. United, this is also same. So, please make a list of the parties which got a same symbol. We also studied about what are the problems or challenges faced by the political parties. That is, one major is the political party, they say that they face a lot of problems because criticisms regarding working of government. Which first one we studied, that there are many political parties, that even though we say political parties are very important for democracy, but there are many examples where within the party only there is no democracy. Means the top leaders are not allowing the lower cadre leaders to open their mouth or give the opinions. And many political parties do not conduct regular elections and give the opportunity to each and everyone to reach to the highest post. So lack of internal democracy, that's very, very problem, challenge faced by the political party. The second one we all studied, that dynastic succession, where generally what happened, if father is very, very successful in political domain, naturally once the father retires, generally there won't, no one retires from political life, but still in case of death, generally his son or his wife, somebody else or his daughter will jump, they contest for election. So it is not a we should not support the dynastic succession, because ruling government is not just like what we are ruling of an empire. That is not correct. That is what another challenge. Third challenge which we, whenever we come across, money and muscle power. Parties spend money for and gundaism and all those things. I told you about lack of meaningful choice. That in India we vote for a political party not because we are happy with the party. We vote because we are not happy with another party. So this is not a meaningful choice. Every political party should have a strong ideology. In India now, very very rarely there is a difference between the ideology of political party. So this is not a good, that is what, these are the challenges to the party. These are all we studied. Then reforms we studied, that is anti-defection law. How now, earlier actually what happened, earlier after the election there were many instances were there where MPs, MLAs will change the party and they will become the ministers. Now if a person, or a person in the sense MP or MLA, changes party, then he will lose his candidature. That is called defection law. So according to defection law, changing party allegiance from the party on which he is got elected to a different party. So now anti-defection law means a person who, if he change the party after the election, definitely will lose his candidature. He has to contest once again election. If he wins, then only he will become MP or MLA. Now it is, what are the suggestion that every political party should make their own bylaws to run the party, and they should maintain a register in which they should maintain the names of their members, and they should also give, very very important, that they should give importance to women, backward caste and others while giving the seats. Now it's very compulsory that every candidate should file an affidavit. Affidavit is nothing but self-declaration. Of course, it's a legal document. Once his affidavit is given, he should give the details about his movable and immovable property, criminal cases if there are any, which is pending. All those things should be given. And affidavit is definitely questionable, in the sense, if a person, if a candidate mentioned something in affidavit and if it is proved wrong, then definitely he will lose his candidature. Okay, so these are the major topics which we studied till now. Please go through the slides once again. Chapter is very important, and I also completed exercise part, question 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, answer to the 7th question, 8, 9, 10, and finally the passage. So with this I completed the revision part of chapter number 6, that is political parties. Take care of yourself, write down all the points and maintain all the notes, question and answers, everything, so that when you are back to the school you are very very comfortable. Take care. I'll meet you in the next class.